so sweet to trust in Jesus, just to take him at his word, just to rest upon his promise, just to know, thus saith the Lord. Oh, how sweet to trust in Jesus, just to trust his cleansing blood, just in simple faith to plunge me, need the healing, cleansing flood. Jesus, Jesus, how I trust him, how I proved him more and more. Jesus, Jesus, precious Jesus, oh, for grace to trust him more. Yes, it is sweet to trust in Jesus, just from sin and self to cease, just from Jesus simply taking life and rest and joy and peace. Jesus, Jesus, how I trust him, how I proved him more and more. Jesus, Jesus, precious Jesus, oh, for grace to trust him more. I'm so glad I learned to trust thee, precious Jesus, Savior, friend. And I know that thou art with me, wilt be with me till the end. Jesus, Jesus, how I trust him, how I proved him more and more. Jesus, Jesus, precious Jesus, oh, for grace to trust him more. Jesus, Jesus, precious Jesus, oh, for grace to trust him more.
At this time, I invite all of our friends to join with me in prayer. Eternal God and ever-loving Father, it is indeed a wonderful privilege that we could call you Father, the great God of our salvation, the one in whom we live and move and have our being. We are thankful, O Lord, that you are our God, and we have this privilege to call upon you. Father, we are living in the most serious time of Earth's history. But we are not afraid, because you have promised that you will be near us. You will never leave us nor forsake us, but that you will be with us even unto the end of the world. And so, dear Father, we want to praise your holy name for who you are. We want to thank you for the blessings day and night, for protection, and for keeping us as your people. Bless our service this evening. Grant that all things will be done to your name's honor and glory. Your name will be praised, be honored, and be glorified, and your people will be blessed. For we ask it in Jesus' name. Amen. Welcome to another Wednesday evening prayer and prayer online service at the House of Prayer of the Hagley Park and Oaklade Seventh-day Adventist Churches. We especially welcome our members and visitors and those who are viewing from our sister churches and non-Adventist friends from at home and abroad. It is indeed a wonderful privilege to be in the house of the Lord and to especially experience the wonderful blessings that God intends to pour out on his people when they come together for such a time as this.
Amen. Praise the Lord. Thank you so much, Elder Joseph, for your welcome and prayer. At this time, we will have our first season of prayer done by Sister Lydia Miles Saunders.
Good evening, everyone. Even though, guys, we're away from each other and the congregation is scattered, and in a time of crisis and we're not able to come together, but we're able to pray together. We thank God for the medium that we have now so that prayers can be shared and, you know, songs can be shared. I don't know about anyone, but if you're struggling to pray, my encouragement for you today is to start out your prayer session with a song of praise. And this is going to be mine before I pray. When I come into his presence, I humble myself. I lift up both my hands and I begin to worship him. Oh yes, I do. I worship him. When I come into his presence, I humble myself. I lift up both my hands and I begin to worship him. I worship him for what he's done for me. You know, as the song says, there might be a storm around us. Things might not be right. You know, there's a lot happening. You know, financially, people might be on a down low. There's a lot happening. Spiritually, you might be flat. But today, I am asking you to worship and to pray and to praise out of principle and not out of feeling. We come in the presence of God and we're going to give him thanks in prayer. Not because of anything he's done. Not because of anything we have done. But simply because he's God. Let us pray. Righteous and eternal God, Lord, today we just want to say thank you on this Wednesday afternoon. We give you thanks because you are God and you're creator of mankind. You saw it fit that today those viewing this session would be alive. We'd be in our right minds, oh God. We'd have the opportunity through the blood of your Son to come before you, to bow and to give you honor and praise. And so despite whatever is happening, and we're not able to gather in church for our formal Wednesday night meeting, and we're not able to leave our homes the way we would want to, and our freedom is snatched, we thank you, God, that in you we have freedom, and that in this life at this time we have freedom of worship and of praise. And so we pause at this moment to say thank you, God, for being a gracious God, for being a loving God, for being a God who does not forget his children. We say thank you for being sovereign God who sits high and look low. But you're not removed from the feelings and the things that affect us. You sent your Son Jesus Christ to have the human experience so that he could, Lord, he could identify with every single struggle that we face in this moment. And so in this moment, oh God, we come, nothing we bring, oh God, but simply to your cross we cling. And we cry, Abba Father, for we have no other help but you. This afternoon, oh God, I pray that you may forgive my sins, and I pray that you may remove Lydia, and that whatever your Holy Spirit may place in my heart to bring to you this afternoon may come as a sweet smelling savor up in your throne room, and that my prayers may be heard. So, dear Father, I come before you on behalf of the members of the Hagley Park Seventh-day Adventist Church, wherever they are. There are people who are struggling with their health. There are people who are struggling with finances. There are people who are struggling with spiritual growth, spiritual death. There are people who are struggling with loss of family members, oh God. There are people who are struggling with loss of health and declining health. There are so many things that is happening to your people at this time. It is a crisis point. But, oh God, we know that anxiety should not be named among us, oh God. We know that, oh God, depression will not be named among us. And so we come and we say, Abba Father, we need you. We pray and we rest all our cares upon you, for you cared for us, oh God. You have promised that in our times we can find shelter in your arms. He said, he that dwelleth in your arms, Lord, there's no other place. There's no other place we'd rather be, for in you there's peace and there's liberty. And so we come with all the things that bother, with all the things that are amassing around your people, and your people are crying out to you because we have no other help. Lord, we know not what is ahead of us. We cannot see. But because we know and we trust the God of the future, we place our hands safely in yours and say, Lord, lead us on. Lead us on to your eternal kingdom. Help us, O God, that as we travel along this weary road, we may not get weary. You say, Lord, the young will get weary, but those that wait upon you will not. And so this afternoon, we place our hand in yours. We pray that we may not get weariness of mind. We may not get physically weary. We may not get spiritually weary. But help us, O Lord, overall not to get weary in well-doing. Help us to place our confidence in you, knowing that you who have started a good work in us will complete it and see to the end. And so we place our members wherever they are in your hands today, O God. We pray for healing for those who are ailing. We pray, O God, for peace for those that you will not heal. We pray, O God, for mercy and grace for those you choose not to heal. And we pray, O Lord, that you may help us, that we may name our burdens as our blessings, and to recognize that you are using these things to refine us and to make us better and to enable us to reach your kingdom, to see your face. This afternoon, O God, we know that there are members that are not even in Jamaica. Some people are in the hard-hit America. Dear Father, we pray that your angels may be, Lord, your angels may just go out into these places where it is so hard hit. I cannot even find words to say. People are trembling for fear. People are fearful. People are anxious. People are depressed, oh God. There are people who are trapped in homes with abusers. There are people who are trapped in abusive homes. Children, women alike, men too. We pray, O Lord, that your Holy Spirit, that your holy angels may provide protection for them, O God. That even in this time, as your people cry on your name, that the hearts of the abusers may be changed and turned towards you. We pray, O Lord, and ask that your people will not be discouraged, that people may find new life and new light in your word, and they might find salvation in your word, and that people may come to you who to know is life eternal. Lord, for the members of the Seventh Adventist Church, especially of the Jamaican community who are living in New York and some of these hard-hit areas, oh God, we pray, like you told the children of Israel, to apply the blood and the death angel will pass over. We pray, oh Lord, that as the blood of your Son, is applied today to these households, that the death angel will pass over, oh God. We pray for protection over all people, over our young children, over our people who have to go out in the work world, who have to earn a living. Lord, as I said the word work, so many people have lost their jobs in this current situation. Some of them did not have savings. They did not have any wealth or anything amassed. And so people who have been living from hand to mouth, oh God, are upon the brink of not just depression, but of hunger and starvation. We pray, O Lord, that you may find a way, that you will impress upon the hearts of those of us who might be able to help in ways that will help your people to be able to make it through this dry and thirsty land. Lord, many of your people are suffering. People are suffering mentally. Some people are trapped. People are trapped in so many different ways. I cannot find words to say. But Lord, today we pray that you may help us to find freedom in you, that we may look beyond what is currently happening now, and that we may find hope and freedom and joy and peace, even in the thought that you said you have gone to prepare a place for me, for us, that where you are, there we may be also, God. And when John saw it, it was beautiful. It was wonderful, oh God. We are now searching for a $2 to buy bread. But you said, oh God, we shall walk upon streets of gold. And we just want to find peace to know that we will be in your presence. That even as today we're giving thanks, we know that the sun is shining, bright, and we're hot. That even the sun will be gone. The S-U-N will be gone. As we will stand in the presence of the S-O-N. And there will be perfect peace. There will be no more sickness. There will be no more corona. There will be no more flu virus. There will be no more need for doctors, nurses. There will be no more need for so many things. We find peace in knowing that where you are, we will be. And that where you are, there is peace forevermore. But Lord, what our reality is now, we need you. We need you in ways that we've never needed you before. And so we pause and we ask you for a special protection over those who work in the health field, the doctors, the nurses, the medical technologies, the nurse assistants, the porters, oh God, the receptionists, so many people are exposed on a daily basis. We just want to ask you for a special protection. In asking for protection, oh God, we just want to say thank you. For you have really cradled Jamaica. You have saved us from the worst of this disease. Lord, we only have 6 deaths, 200 and something cases. But we know that it's because of your mighty hand and your grace and your power why we have been spared in such a way. And so I know I'm not the only one calling on you. And I know you have been honoring your people as they call on you. And so we pray, oh God, that the prayers, as the prayers go up, your blessings and your protection will come down. That at the end of this pandemic, at the end of this destruction, oh God, your people in Jamaica can stand and say, surely there has been a God in Jamaica who protected his people. We are seeing it now, and we just want to give you praise and thanks for it. And pray, oh God, that it may be perpetuated throughout this entire season so that our death rate will not be much. That your people, oh God, you will strengthen our immune systems. That you will boost your people spiritually, physically, oh God. And that we may come out of it giving praise and honor to the God of creation. For he has rescued us from this wicked, and I don't even know what this wicked disease, oh God. Lord, we pray for our leaders of this country. You may give them wisdom. You may give them knowledge and understanding. That, oh God, your Holy Spirit may pursue them. That you may bring them back one to your fold. You may rescue them from sin, death, and the grave. People are interested in not catching coronavirus. But Lord, I am interested in people being rescued from the virus of sin. Help us, oh God, that as we are seeking to protect ourselves from this physical virus, that we may seek to protect our hearts and our minds from the spiritual virus of sin that is killing us every day. People die in sin every single day. The world seems not to care. But today we pause to pray, to say to you, oh God, may your Holy Spirit impress upon our minds as we cover our... Lord, as your people, as the world rushes on, oh God, to cover our noses, to cover our mouths, to wash our hands, may we be more interested in the covering of our souls, Lord, in the guarding of our minds and the avenues of our souls, in washing ourselves in the blood of your Son, Jesus Christ, so that we may come out, O God, white as snow, so that we may be ready when you shall put in your appearance. May, O God, may we take lessons from this crisis, this COVID-19 crisis, to recognize, O God, that you are even at the door. That you, O God, are even at the door, and we are not ready. Help us, O God. Help us to be interested in the refashioning of our lives, in the remaking of our souls, so that we may be ready to hail you as Lord and Savior of our lives at the end of it all, O God. May we be ready to spend eternity with you when we would have laid down every care, every burden, and life on earth will be no more. May we recognize and remember that your call on us today is for a call of change and a call of readiness to be prepared to go forth in this end time, to be a people, O God, that is washed in the blood of the Lamb and who have no more effects of the sin, the virus of sin, to live on the earth made new. So I just want to pause and say thank you, God. Thank you for hearing answering prayers. Thank you, God, that we have an avenue. We have somebody we can talk to. Somebody we can rest our cares upon. In Jesus' name, amen.
We will have a musical selection by Brother Anil Beckford.
I can do all things through Christ who gives me strength, but sometimes I wonder what he can do to me. No great success to show, no glory of my own, yet in my weakness he is there to let me know. His strength is perfect when our strength is gone. He'll carry us when we can't carry on. Great is his power, the weak become strong. His strength is perfect, his strength is perfect. We can only know power that he holds when we truly see how deep our weakness goes. His strength in us begins when ours comes to an end. He hears our humble cry and proves again. Strength is perfect when our strength is gone. He'll carry us when we can't carry on. Great is his power, the weak become strong. His strength is perfect, strength is perfect. Great is his power, the weak become strong. His strength is perfect, his strength is perfect.
Thank you so much, Brother Anil, for that lovely rendition. And at this time, After such a beautiful song that blessed our hearts, we will have a season of prayer by Elder Kevil Joseph. Kevil Joseph.
My friends, let me invite you once again to a season of prayer as we bow our heads before the Lord our Maker. What a friend we have in Jesus, all our sins and griefs to bear. What a privilege to carry everything to God in prayer. Father in heaven, we are so grateful this evening that we could call you Father, knowing that you are the great God of the universe, the one that spoke and it was done, the one that commanded and it stood fast. We are thankful to know that you are in charge of the affairs of this world. And everything that is happening, dear God, nothing happens that you have not allowed. And so, dear God, even though we are living in a terrible time, in a terrible crisis of this COVID-19 virus, we are still encouraged to send up our petitions to you because we know that you are in charge. Father in heaven, there are many persons who are suffering everywhere. Overseas and at home, people are suffering, people are dying, but we know that you are our God and you are in charge of every situation, and we know that we could come and call upon your holy name. And so, dear Father, we ask of you for a special blessing upon your people. We ask of you, Lord, to comfort those who have suffered loss of their loved ones. There are many persons who are being affected, and the virus is still spreading. There are many persons, Lord, who have been isolated because of this virus that is going on. Father, this is something that has gotten the world's attention. And Lord, we believe that you are the God that can bring good out of evil. And so even though many persons are suffering from this terrible virus, we know, dear God, that all things work together for good for them that love the Lord, for them that are the called according to your purpose. So, dear Lord, let your purpose be worked out and be fulfilled in our lives. I know, dear God, that you are able to draw many to you, even under these dire circumstances. And it is possible, dear Lord, that many more of your people will be saved because of this situation. So let your name be praised, be honored, and be glorified, and your people be blessed. We wait upon you, dear Father, for your special blessing. We wait upon you for your special protection. I pray, dear God, that you will be with us in the land of Jamaica. I pray, dear God, that you will be with your people everywhere, in every land, and in every situation, dear God. Father, let us not be afraid. Cause us not to fear, but you, because you have promised that even though we walk through the valley of the shadow of death, you promise that you will be with us. Your rod and your staff will comfort us. You promise, Lord, that you will never leave us nor forsake us. And so, dear God, we rest in assurance of your words. We are resting upon your promise. We take it as our security. And so, dear Father, we are thankful that in you we are blessed. And so, dear Father, continue to be with us. Keep us. Give us the upward look. Comfort every feeble-minded person. Grant that your people would not be afraid, but their faith will look up to you, whom to know is life eternal. I pray, dear God, out of this terrible situation, you will bring about such a good that many more people would be saved for your eternal kingdom than if this situation had never existed. So dear Father, we commit our lives into your hands. We ask of you for your blessing upon your people. We ask of you for the blessing upon this ministry. We ask of you for your blessing upon our leaders, our pastors, and your people everywhere. That in all of this, your name would be honored, be praised, and be glorified. And your people would be blessed in a special way as we give thanks and praise you in Jesus' most wonderful name. Amen.
Amen. Amen. Praise the Lord. Thank you so much, Elder Joseph, for that mighty powerful prayer. Indeed, the prayer of the righteous availeth much. This time we will have a musical selection by leader Marlene Reed Little.
Things change, plans fail. You look for love on a grander scale. Storms rise, hopes fail, and you place your bet on another day. When the going gets tough, when the ride's too rough, and you're just not sure enough, Jesus will still be there. His love will never change, as sure as a steady rain. Jesus will still be there. When no one else is true, he'll still be loving you. When it looks like you've lost it all and you haven't got a prayer, Jesus will still be there. Times fly, hearts turn, a little bit wiser from lessons learned. Sometimes weakness wins and you lose your guard all once again. When the going gets tough, when the ride's too rough, and you're just not sure enough, Jesus will still be there. His love will never change, as sure as a steady rain. Jesus will still be there. When no one else is true, he'll still be loving you. When it looks like you've lost it all and you haven't got a prayer, Jesus will still be there. Jesus will still be there. His love will never change, as sure as a steady rain. Jesus will still be there. When no one else is true, he'll still be loving you. When it looks like you've lost it all and you have got a prayer, Jesus will still be there. When it looks like you've lost it all and you have got a prayer, Jesus will still be
Thank you so much, Leader Little, for that beautiful song. Indeed, God is good. He is awesome, and he is worthy to be praised. Thank you so much, Elder Joseph, for that powerful prayer. Indeed, God is the one who hears and answers prayer. And indeed, his ears are always open to our supplication. Welcome again to another evening of the House of Prayer. I'd like to also welcome our viewers, our friends, members, community members, even friends and non-Adventists who are viewing on the various social media platforms, YouTube, Facebook, Instagram. You may be here in Jamaica, you may be abroad. Welcome once again to the evening of the House of Prayer. This evening, I am your host, Pastor Michael Jr. We will have the second part to last week. Last week we had successful prayer. That was part one. This week we will have successful prayer, part two. And so our focus is the Psalm 138, verse 1 to 3. Let us pray. Gracious, mighty God and O Father, we thank you for being with us again another week. Lord, we invite your divine Holy Spirit presence to be with us. May you lead me, use me, speak through me. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. Successful prayer, part 2. In the day when I cried, thou answered me and strengthened me. By reading the context of our opening text, we note that this prayer is an expression of thanksgiving. The psalmist was a man filled with gratitude, a man who was always in the attitude of thanksgiving, an attitude of gratitude. In fact, most of the psalm were acknowledgement by the psalmist of the Lord's care for him against his deadly enemies, who were merely many. Our text here is therefore a joyful retrospect in which he writes of successful prayer. Now, beloved friends, viewers, there are three high points in our subject today. The psalmist's prayer is an earnest prayer. And he's saying that earnest prayer is heard in heaven. James 5 and verse 16 tells us, the effectual fervent prayer of a righteous man availeth much. And also, Daniel 9 and verse 3, and I set my face unto the Lord my God to seek by prayer and supplication with fasting and sackcloth and ashes. It was a prayer offered in childlike simplicity and faith. This is the key to successful prayer. Faith is one of the key ingredients to a successful prayer life. If you will turn to Matthew 9, which speaks about the woman that touched the hem of Jesus' garment, that woman who had the issue of blood for 12 years, tried everything she possibly could, but to no avail. All her help, external help and money and doctors were of no value. But until the day that Jesus was in town, she said, if I but touch the hem of his garment, I shall be whole. You could talk about even the centurion, who his servant was ill and he came to Jesus. But he said, Lord, you do not need to come under my roof, for I am a man of authority. And when I say go, they go. And he said, Lord, just speak the word and my servant will be healed. Immediately, his servant was healed because of his faith. This was a man who was not a Christian, was not a Jew then, so to speak, but yet he had faith. Faith in God can move mountains out of our lives. Matthew 21 verse 22 encourages us by saying, all things whatsoever he shall ask in prayer, believing, he shall receive. Men ought always to pray and not faint. Dr. Luke, in Luke 18 and verse 1, we are to be consistent in prayer. We are to have faith that God will hear and answer prayer. Now, beloved friends, answers to prayer is, as all other blessings, conditional. Yes, they are conditional. We must pray in accordance with the holy will of God. 1 John 5 and verse 14 declares that we must pray in accordance with the will of God. Our Savior sets us an example. And if you turn to Matthew 26, verse 42. Let me find a scripture for you. You can find it on your tablet, on your phone. He went away a second time and prayed, "My Father, if this cup cannot be taken away unless I drink it, your will must be done." And this is the New English Translation. So, beloved friends, the will of God must be understood. The will of God must be incorporated in our prayers. And so, when we pray, we need to pray bearing in mind the will of God. Men ought always to pray. Yes, our Savior set that example. Point number two, the successful issue of prayer. Thou answerest me. In Psalm 6 and verse 8, and even Psalm 18, verse 6 and 22 and verse 4, God does hear and answers prayer when it is for our own good and to the glory of his wonderful name. Yes, if you're wondering why sometimes our prayers are not answered, it's because our prayers are selfish. It's because God's name will not be glorified. As long as God's name will be glorified, then God will be more than happy to answer our prayers. He may not answer our prayers in the form that we expect. So true. God healed Naaman, the leper, but not as he wanted to be healed. You can always check this in 2 Kings 5, verse 9 to 14. Now, Naaman, the leper, powerful man, wanted to be healed, but not in dirty Jordan. But the prophet said, "Unless you go and dip 7 times in dirty Jordan, then you shall be healed." So Naaman went in faith, went to dirty Jordan. Yes, stood in Jordan, dipped first time, dipped the second, dipped the third, dipped the fourth, dipped the fifth and the sixth, and looked at himself. Still was not clean, but until he went to the very last word of God, the 7th time, he came up with skin of a newborn baby. Isn't this wonderful that God answers prayer, even though at times not as all we wanted? Jesus, in Luke 17, verses 12 to 14, he told the 10 lepers to go and show themselves to the priests. And it was when they went that they were cleansed. Notice that they had to play a part in carrying out this healing process. Jesus told them to go. They had to move. They were hereby exercising their faith. My friends, viewers, social media, YouTube, Facebook, Instagram, whichever media, whichever platform you're on, when you pray, step out in faith. Decree it in faith. Claim it in faith. And by faith, God will do great things for you. If our prayers are not answered, there may be things in our lives that is preventing the Lord from hearing us. Examples, Isaiah 59 in verse 2, as one of the texts I shared with you last week. Note what the Lord says to us through the prophet. Your iniquities have separated between you and your God, and your sins have hid his face from you, that he will not hear you. Psalmist also said in Psalm 66 and verse 18, if I regard iniquity in my heart, the Lord will not hear me. Beloved friends, before you pray, search yourself. Do some self-inspection. Before you pray for others, do some self-inspection. Am I having iniquity in my heart? Am I holding up a grudge? Am I holding on to hurt? Am I holding on to something that I need to let go? Now, if I am doing so, then I must let go so that God will be able to hear and answer my supplication. Number three, conditions of successful prayer. Experience shows that some people's prayers are much more successful than others. Truth be told, yes, this is indeed true. That raises the question, why? Why is it that some person's prayer are answered, mine is not? Why is it that some person's prayers are successful and others are not? God is not a respecter of person. Yes, you may be thinking that if this is so, that some person's prayers are being answered and some are not, then God is a God who is partial, who shows partiality or have favorites. Like some of us as human beings, we too are guilty of having favorites. Yes, even in a church setting, some of us, we may have favorite elders, favorite leaders, favorite deacons, favorite deaconesses. In our family members, we have our favorite child. Yes, favorite sibling. Whatever our favoritism is, God is not like humans. And I am happy that God is not like humans. He doesn't think as how we as humans at times will think. He doesn't behave and respond as how we as human, we as humans will think and behave and respond. Now, beloved friends, are we sure that God is not a respecter of persons? If you turn with me to the book of Acts, Acts chapter 10 and verses 34 and 35, hear what the word of the Lord says. I'm reading from the New English Translation. Then Peter started speaking. I now truly understand that God does not show favoritism in dealing with people. But in every nation, the person who fears him and does what is right is welcome before him. Here, God does not show favoritism. God is not partial. Isn't this good news? To know that when I pray, God will not show partiality towards me. Beloved friends, God is not a respecter of person, class, status, color of our skin. He loves everyone. He died for the world. He died for you and me. It must be because of that which is associated with prayer. James 4 and verse 3. Turn with me to James 4 and verse 3. It says, you ask and do not receive because you ask amiss. Another rendition or translation would say, you ask and do not receive because you ask wrongly, so you can spend it on your passions. Isn't this powerful? Isn't this something that you perhaps may have overlooked? Isn't this something that you may have brushed aside? But here the Bible is clear. The word of God is clear that sometimes we ask wrongly. Sometimes we ask selfishly. because we want to gratify our own passions, our own lust, our own selfish desires. And so God will not answer the prayer of selfishness. God also, in Romans 8 verse 26, in the same way, the Spirit helps us in our weakness. For we do not know how we should pray, but the Spirit himself intercedes for us with inexpressibly groanings. My friends, there are many times we do not know how to pray. And I too can admit, there are times I would want to pray and I don't know what to pray about. I don't know how to begin. But just to sit in silence and wait on the Lord and allow His Spirit to lead me, then I am led into a powerful, authentic, unselfish prayer for my brothers and sisters. We must pray according to the will of God, as mentioned before. But I want to dig a little deeper into this will of God. The word will comes from a Greek word called telema, meaning what one wishes or has determined shall be done. What is this saying? It is saying that we must pray in accordance to God's will, to God's wishes. When Jesus prayed in the garden, he said, "Lord, if it's possible, let this cup pass from me. Let not my will, but thy will be done." The will of Jesus as a human being, the human side, came in prominence at this particular period in time. The human side cried out and said, "I would love to have this cup pass from me." But Jesus, knowing his purpose, knowing the will of the Father, said, "Father, let not my will, but thy will be done." That is what Jesus did at all times. That is why God hears us when we pray, if it's accordance with his will. Speaking about the will of God, I remember it was 2018, just before graduation, and my grandmother was ill. At this time, it was about June, July. Graduation would be August. And I prayed and I said, "Lord, if there's one request I need from you, is to have my grandmother live to see my graduation." I did pray it in the name of Jesus Christ. I did decree it and declare it by faith. And I did say, "Lord, let your will be done. If you will grant me this one wish, have mercy." Beloved friends, the Lord gave me my wish in accordance with his will. He granted the answers to my prayers. That very day of graduation, though my grandmother was healed with a heart problem, she could hardly walk. She was able to walk in that auditorium. When the president called my name, she was able to see me walk across the podium to collect my degree. God is indeed a God who hears and answers prayer, as long as we place our will in the will of God. Even the Holy Spirit, as mentioned before, helps us to pray. We have heard, when we pray in the blessed name of our Lord and Savior, Jesus Christ, that there is power. Acts 4 in verse 12 declares that there is no other name under heaven by which men shall be saved except the name of Jesus. The name of Jesus is powerful. Speaking of the name of Jesus, I can't help but remembering as Paul was teaching and preaching, sharing the good news of salvation, the gospel. There was a set of brethren, a set of Jews, the sons of Sceva, if I'm pronouncing it correctly. These men were, there were some men who were possessed with the devil. And these Jews said, we command you to come out in the name of the God whom Paul serves. He calls upon the name of the God who Paul calls upon. Now, what really strikes me is that they are calling upon the God whom Paul preaches, but they did not know this God. Beloved friends, when we call upon God in prayer, when we pray in the name of the Lord, it's not just praying in the name of the Lord and things will happen. You must know the Lord. To know the Lord by name means that you have a relationship with God. It doesn't matter if your faith is weak. It doesn't matter if your faith is great. As long as you have faith, as long as you are in a growing relationship with God, he hears and answers prayer. John 15 and verse 16 tells us, whatsoever ye shall ask in my name, ask the Father in my name, he will give it to you. The name of Jesus is a key to all thoughts, words, and actions of the children of God. In closing, I want you to be mindful that one, we must forgive. We must confess our sins. We must sincerely pray not to be selfish. We must have childlike faith. Faith in God can move mountains. Without faith, it is impossible to please God. Persevere in prayer. Do not give up, no matter what the situation is. Pray until something happens. At this time, we will have a special selection done by Brother Renato Miles.
I have journeyed through the long dark night, out on the open sea. By faith alone, sight unknown, then yet his eyes were watching me. The anchor holds, though the ship is battered, the anchor, though the sails are torn, I have fallen on my knees as I face the raging seas. Well, the anchor holds in spite of the storm. I've had visions, and I've had dreams, and I've even held them in my hands, but I never knew, hey, that they slip right through it. Like they were only, only grains of sand. Oh, the anchor holds. Though the ship is battered, the anchor holds. Though the sails are torn, for I have fallen on my knees as I face the raging sea, but the anchor holds in spite of the storm. Well, I have been young, but I am older now, and there has been beauty these eyes have seen. Oh, but it was in the night, through the storms of my life. Oh, that's when God proved His love to me. Though the ship is battered, the anchor holds. Though the sails are torn, I have fallen on my knees as I face the rain. See the anchor holds in spite of the storm. I have fallen on my knees as I face the raging sea. The anchor spite of the storm. Yeah.
Though the ship is battered, the anchor holds. Reminds me of the songwriter says, we have an anchor that keeps the soul steadfast and sure while the billows roll. Praise the Lord. Great, mighty, and awesome God, we humble ourselves before you. Lord, I come to you in the mighty and saving name of Jesus Christ, my Lord and my Savior. Have mercy on me, O God, as I seek to petition your throne on behalf of my brethren, on behalf of those who are viewing online, those who have not yet given their lives wholeheartedly to you. Mighty God, may you take a live coal from the altar and place it at my lips. May you purge me of all my sins and all unrighteousness. O God, have mercy on Jamaica, land we love. Have mercy upon your people, upon your children. Mighty God, we are going through challenging times, but we know that with you, we can smile at the storm. Oh Lord, oh God, we place before you the prayer request for healing. Those who are in need of physical healing, may you speak the word of healing to their bodies right now. Lord, those who are in need of emotional healing, many are suffering, oh God, of hurts from the past. Many, oh God, are perplexed. Many, oh God, are struggling to let go of the past. And so, God, give those individuals in the name of Jesus Christ the will and the power to let go so that they can embrace the present and look forward to the future. Mighty God, you are the great master surgeon. You are the great physician. Oh God, I pray that you will speak to that individual right now who is suffering from cancer. My God, may you nullify and cramp and paralyze every tissue, every cell of cancer in the name of Jesus Christ of Nazareth. Oh God, we decree and we declare healing for those who are suffering with diabetes. We decree and we declare healing, oh God, for those who are suffering, those who have been physically abused, those who have been mentally abused. Mighty God, those who have been raped, who are struggling, oh God, who have lost your dignity. But mighty God, I pray that you will move afresh alongside your children. May they feel your loving arms around them, oh God. May you be to them, oh God, a shelter in the time of storm. Lord, we pray for our professionals, or doctors or nurses who are out on the front line giving service to their fellow men, working, Lord, to improve the health and lives of their neighbors. Mighty God, may you create an edge round about them. May you protect them from COVID-19 and all other viruses. Lord, may you guide and protect their going out and their coming in. Lord, may you give them the patience that they need in this trying time. Lord, they're standing on your feet for long hours, sleepless hours. Mighty God, may you give them that spirit of calm in the midst of fear. Lord, may you give them wisdom to deal with the challenges that they interface with. May you be with the technicians, the assistant nurses, the nurses. May you be with the police officers, soldiers, security personnel who are going on the front line to help to maintain the law and order of Jamaica and other various countries that have been affected by COVID-19. Lord, we pray for the families of those who are serving on the front line. Lord, they are wondering if their husband, if their wife will return home, if their father, if their mother will return home to them. Oh God, may you give them the assurance that you are still in charge. Mighty God, we pray for those who are vulnerable. We pray, oh God, for the mentally challenged during this time. We pray that you will provide for them. We pray, oh God, that you will surround them with your atmosphere of calm and peace. Mighty God, we pray for the leadership of the church, the Seventh-day Adventist Church. May you continue to inspire. May you continue to impart wisdom as we lead. Oh God, may you give us the unction to function in such a time as this. Lord, we pray for our seniors. Oh Lord, we pray that you will revitalize them, re-energize them. We pray, oh God, that you will use this moment, oh God, to help them to lean on the arms of Jesus. Mighty God, may you motivate them to read your word some more, to pray some more, to meditate on your love, to meditate on your goodness for such a time as this. Thank you for being the God who hears. Thank you for being the God who answers prayer as we claim the victory in the name of Jesus Christ, our Lord and our Savior, according to your will, in Jesus' name. Amen. thank you so much for being with us as we look forward to seeing you again or to being with you again next week. Until then, keep true. Until then, keep faithful. Pray without ceasing. Pray until something happens. Let go and let God. We want to let you know that we still have our virtual church going on. Friday evenings, we have our lesson review. We have our Sabbath service, Sabbath school. Midday service, we have Bible class, AY. Sunday evenings, we have the spiritual transition with our host pastor, Pastor Omar Oliphant. And of course, on Wednesday evenings, we have the house of prayer. May God bless you as you continue to hold fast in such a time as this. Be blessed and be a blessing. Amen.